करंट टॉपिक इज टिश्यूज इन बॉडी एंड देयर टाइप. बिफोर डिस्कसिंग अबाउट टिश्यू, फर्स्ट वी शुड नो हाउ दिस टिश्यूज फॉर्म. सो ऑल द टिश्यूज आर मेड अप ऑफ सेल एंड वी ऑल नो सेल्स आर द बेसिक फंक्शनल यूनिट ऑफ द लाइफ एंड ऑल सेल्स आर डिराइव्ड फ्रॉम प्री एग्जिस्टिंग सेल. इट मीन कि सेल कैन बी फॉर्म्ड, इट कैन रिप्रोड्यूस विद द प्रीवियस सेल और मदर सेल. द थर्ड कैरेक्टरिस्टिक ऑफ द सेल ह्यूमन सेल और एनिमल सेल इज बाउंडेड बाय सेलेक्टिवली परमेबल मेम्ब्रेन. दिस इज द बेसिक कैरेक्टरिस्टिक ऑफ ह्यूमन सेल एंड ओनली बिकॉज ऑफ प्रेजेंस ऑफ लिविंग सेलेक्टिवली परमेबल मेम्ब्रेन ह्यूमन सेल इज डिफरेंट फ्रॉम एनिमल सेल. सो व्हाई दिस मेम्ब्रेन, व्हाट इज द सेल, हाउ, व्हाट आर द कंपोनेंट विच इज present inside the cell. Cell include various organelles and these organelles are classified as membrane bound organelles and non membrane bound organelles. When you see cell from the outside, the outermost covering of cell is cell membrane. As I have told you, cell membrane is semi permeable or selectively permeable structure. What is semi permeability or selectively permeability? It means the cell membrane, which is covering all of the internal component of cell, is selectively permeable for some of the structure, some of the chemical, and not allowing all of the structure to go inside the cell. So why our cell is having this property? Why the cell membrane is having property of selectively permeability? The selective permeability of cell membrane is because of the cell membrane is made up of phospholipid, cholesterol and protein and some amount of attached carbohydrate. You can see in the diagram all cell membrane is looking like there is some amount of gap between two cells of cell membrane. That's why this cell membrane is permeable for some of the material but not permeable for or not selective. It is only and only selectively permeable for some of the material. Now come to the movement of how, what is the importance of selective permeability of cell membrane? What is the main function? How this cell membrane is helping a cell by its selective membrane, selectively permeable property? It is allowing movement of substances in and out of the cell. So let us discuss the importance of this selective permeability of the cell membrane. So transport of any material inside the cell or out the cell may be because of two types. First is passive type and next is active type. What is passive mobility? In passive movement of any material inside the cell or from inside the cell to out the cell doesn't require any energy. Substance move from greater to lesser concentration. This is the basic rule. When anything will come from cell to outside, when the concentration of cell material will be higher than the concentration of outside, what happens? Internal content or internal fluid of cell will come out through membrane. And when the concentration of outside the cell will be higher than the concentration of the inside material of cell, the outer material will come in the cell. And this is the mechanism of swelling. Whenever the cell is having less concentration than outside area, cell will absorb more amount of water and fluid and resulted in swelling form. So in passive transmission of material, no carrier required lipid soluble substance. All lipid soluble substance can come in the cell and go out from the cell by passive means. They don't require any energy to come in or go out from the cell. Carrier or special pore required polar or water soluble substance. It means there is water soluble substance or polar substance, they can easily come inside the cell and go out of. So those substances which are having capability of solubility in water, they can easily travel across the membrane either inside or outside. The second mode of transport through cell membrane is active transport. In active transport, energy required from lesser to greater concentration. Carrier involve endocytosis to and exocytosis. What is endocytosis? Endocytosis means cell. If anything come inside the cell, if anything, any material is coming inside the cell is known as endocytosis, and if any material is going outside the cell is known as exocytosis. Now come to the structure of cell. I have told you cell is the basic functional unit of life, and a cell is having all characteristic of living. A cell is showing all characteristic of living. And when we see cells are very small, in very small, tiny, it may be ranges from micron to angstrom and ranges up to centimeter, like nerve cell and muscle cell. They are longer enough, we can see by our naked eyes. But some cells like bacteria, virus, they are very much small, their size in angstrom, we cannot see. So to see them, we need some microscope or electron microscope to visualize them. So I have told you cell size and diameter ranges from angstrom to some of the centimeter. And when you see cell from outside, the outermost covering of cell is cell membrane, which is made up of lipoprotein. And I have told you that membrane is selectively permeable for some of the material. As I can show in the diagram, when you divide or classify a cell in different structure, it is having a cell membrane, then cytoplasm, and many organelles of cells is present in the cytoplasm. So from outermost covering is cell membrane, whole the liquid fluid is covered by membrane, and the liquid is known as cytoplasm. The fluid which is present inside the cell membrane of the cell is known as cytoplasm. And in the cytoplasm, many important structure which are the functional unit of life is present inside the cytoplasm, and they are known as organelles of cell. And these organelles could be non-membranous or it could be membranous. So non-membranous material or cellular structure or any structure which are not liquid, they are direct in contact with cytoplasm. Those organelles which is not having a membrane, it's on its outside, they are always remain in direct contact with cytoplasm. But membranous organelles surround by one or two lipid bilayer membrane, it means the outermost covering of cell wall, and those structures which are present inside the cell, some of the structures is also having cell membrane. Now come to membrane. I would like to explain something about those organelles which are having membrane around it. The first and most important organelles which is present inside that cell and which is bound in membrane is nucleus. Nucleus is the core of any cell. Nucleus is having all genetic material like DNA. DNA is the basic material for reproduction. Production of same offspring. It is the DNA, and DNA is having all the genetic coding by which the characteristic of a person is decided. Okay, a child will exhibit which characteristic is only and only decided by DNA. And the cell division, growth, how we can grow from 1 inch to 1 meter, it is decided by DNA. So these structure, DNA is the basic unit of life. So DNA is present inside the nucleus. The second structure is endoplasmic reticulum. Third is vesicle, Golgi apparatus, lysosome, peroxisome, and mitochondria. So I will discuss one by one in detail. First is nucleus. What is nucleus? Large organelles with double membrane nucleus envelope contain 46 human chromosome. As I have told you, the nucleus is the most important structure of cell, and the DNA, which is the basic controlling system of the whole human characteristic as well as reproduction, is DNA, and that DNA is having 46 chromosome in human being. Outer membrane continuous with rough endoplasmic reticulum. Outside the nucleus, there is a lining, a structure known as endoplasmic reticulum, and there are some other structures which are present inside the nucleus is nucleolus. Nucleus is a site of ribosome assembly. Ribosome is the other important structure of cell which is responsible for production of protein. So the two important structure, DNA and RNA, are exhibited within the nucleus and nucleolus. So nucleus is also playing important role in cell division. We will discuss later when we will go through cell division process. Now come to the non-membranous bound organelles of cell. One is ribosome, cytoskeleton, microvilli and flagella. These structures, they are now covered with the outer covering. Ribosome, I have told you, this is the organ which is responsible for production of protein. Cytoskeleton. Cytoskeleton means the whole structure which form the cell. And by microvilli is some group which is utilized to absorb more nutrition. And last one is flagella for the motility of some material fluid within the cell. By the movement of cilia and flagella, they can facilitate the flow of fluid within the cell. Now I will describe one by one what is cytoskeleton. Lattice of protein fiber extending through cytoplasm. What is cytoskeleton? Which frame the whole skeletal system of cell. What is the function of cytoskeleton? The main function of cytoskeleton is movement of cellular components, cellular structure, support the one cell structure, it gives a shape. A skeleton is always responsible for making shape of whole body. So, cytoskeleton of cell is responsible for making a cell. Our body has different shape and sizes of cell, and the different shape, long cell, columnar cell, ovoid cell, these are there. We have different types of cell in our body tissues. So the shape of body tissue is decided by the presence of or type of cytoskeleton. And the next function of cytoskeleton is anchoring movement of organelle cell part. Whatever organelle is present inside the cell, the movement of those organelles is supported by the cytoskeleton. And the last and but not least, the function of cytoskeleton is anchoring cell together. Anchoring cell together means because cytoskeleton make the outermost covering of the cell, structure of cell. So it is going to when one cell is going to attach with other cell, the both cytoskeleton attaches and make a tissue. So I have told you, cell is the smallest unit. When many cells unite, it forms the tissues. So cytoskeleton also help in attachment of one cell with the other cell. And the last function of cytoskeleton is constantly rearrange. It means whenever tissue is required, suppose if you are going to contract your muscle, the shape of muscle is changes. And when you are going to lengthen your muscle, the shape is changes. So during any mobility, during any changes, these cytoskeleton has capability to adopt their shape according to demand. So these are the function of cytoskeleton. How cytoskeleton forms? Cytoskeleton is formed by the microfilament. They are the thin filament. And if we talk about the muscle, the cytofilament, suppose I have taken an example of muscle. Muscle is a cell which is having a high length, the highest length, 30 centimeter. A cell, muscle cell is approximately around 30 centimeter in length and few micrometer in diameter. So if I would like to explain the structure of cell with the example of muscle, and if we take muscle as an example of cell, and we talk what is the cytoskeleton of muscle, is microfilament from which a muscle cell is formed. So muscle cell is a form of cytoskeleton, and cytoskeleton of muscle is microfilament. They are mainly actin is the thinnest filament, muscle contraction and support microvilli. What is the function of actin? Actin is responsible for muscle contraction. Second is intermediate filament of cytoskeleton is several different protein, anchor organelles. Thick filament is myosin. So when we take example of muscle as a cell, it is made up of two cytoskeleton. One is thin cytoskeleton is actin, and other cytoskeleton is myosin. And when we see a sarcomere length, many actin and myosin are arranged over one another and make a complete functional unit of muscle which perform movement. Now come to other structure which are responsible for formation of cytoskeleton is microtubules, large cylindrical structure. They are large cylindrical structure composed of tubulin protein, flagella, cilia and centrosome. They are also present in that skeleton. As we have seen in muscle contraction, with the muscle contraction is not possible, or actin and myosin overlapping is not possible until the calcium release from our sarcoplasmic retinaculum. So sarcoplasmic retinaculum is a part of cytoskeleton which is attached with the actinomycin, and whenever any action potential come from nerve, it stimulates the release of calcium from sarcoplasmic retinaculum and releases those calcium to the actinomycin and causes muscle contraction. Now come to the function of what is cilia and flagella. The next organelle of cell is cilia and flagella. What is the function of cilia and flagella? First function of cilia and flagella, they are thread-like structure of cell and constantly moving. Even we have some cilia in our intestinal wall, and because of presence of cilia in intestinal wall, our intestine is able to absorb digest food. Otherwise, if you don't have any cilia, our intestine will not be able to digest food. So presence of cilia is very much important in a cell. And what is the function? First function is movement. They are continuously moving in the cell, and by moving they are arranging, rearranging the tissue fluid as well as the cell, adapted to move things out of the area like the respiratory tract. Adapted to move things out of the area like the respiratory tract. We have cilia in our respiratory tract. They are trying to move in and out things, because by movement, like if you think throw something, so it can move the object present in those areas. Both same basic structure. What is the composition of cilia? Shorter cilia and large cilia. We have discussed about the different component and function of cell. What is the function of cell? I have told you this is the basic unit of life. All the organelles, all the structure which are responsible for life is present in cell. So cell is a house. Cell is a house where all requirement of body, like adaptation, whether it's energy production, food absorption, excretion, each and every function is available. Even electrical transfer, nerve conduction, everything is present inside the cell. Now come to the tissues. I have told you tissues are made up of cells. So we have discussed in brief about the cell. Now come to the different types of tissues which are present in our body, or in other words, we can say our human body or animal body is made up of four types of tissues. What are tissues? Tissues are the group of cells. Tissues are the number of cells unite and make a tissue. So tissue group of similarly specialized cell performing a similar function. We have cell, but different cells are responsible for different types of function. Like cells of intestine, it is responsible for digestive work or absorption work. Cells of respiration are responsible for respiratory work. Cells of heart is responsible for cardiac work. But when these cells unite together, they are responsible for same function. So same types of cell unite together and form a tissue, and one tissue is responsible for one function. So there are four types of tissue. First is epithelial tissue, second is muscle tissue, third is connective tissue, and fourth is nervous tissue. So our body is having four different types of tissues: epithelial tissues, muscle tissues, connective tissues, and nervous tissues. How can we study these tissues? How can we see these tissues? So histology is a branch of medical science. By using that science, we can analyze, we can see, we can differentiate between the different types of tissue. So histology is a branch by which we can examine tissues. So first I would like to discuss about the epithelial tissues. What is first type of tissues in body is epithelial tissues. What is the function of epithelial tissues? The main function of epithelial tissues is production, absorption, secretion. Production, absorption, and secretion. As we have seen, our outermost covering of skin is made up of epithelial tissues. Dermis and epidermis is made up of epithelial tissues. And the main function of our skin is production of our body or different cells from development of infection, as well as absorption. Mean skin is ability to absorb any useful things or whichever is applied or our body, it is having ability to absorb. So if we apply anything over the epithelial cell, because of semi permeability or selective permeability nature of the epithelial cell, it can absorb the outer thing inside, and it can also secrete. If anything is waste, unutilized or not required. If anything is not required inside the cell, it can be excreted out or secreted from the cell. So, sweating. What is sweating? Whenever our body temperature is increases because of excessive exercises, excessive work, or excessive heat production in our body, so body is trying to excrete excessive amount of heat with the help of excretion. So, and secretion of that excessive heat with the help of water as well as some metabolites with the help of our skin, and skin is made up of epithelial tissues. So, I have told you epithelial tissues has three important function: protection of body from infection and foreign bodies, absorption of useful things through the permeable membrane, and third is secretion of waste thing which is present inside the cell by the epithelial cell. Now, cover all, virtually all body surface in and out. Epithelium is the outermost covering of our body, and it cover whole body through a formation of epithelial cell. Lack of vascular supply. Lack of, it means epithelial cell doesn't have maximal amount of blood. Maximum amount of blood supply in epithelial cell, because it is the outermost covering, so outermost covering doesn't require much more energy. So, less amount of vascular supply is given by the vascular system to the epithelial cell. And we can classify epithelial cell on the basis of shape and stacking of cell. Mean we can classify different type of epithelial cell on the basis of their shape. Generally supported on the basement membrane and connective tissues. It means the main where it is present in the body, mainly it is present on the basement membrane. Basement membrane means covering of a cell is made up of epithelial cell as well as some of the connective tissues. The outer covering of all connective tissues is made up of epithelial cell. Now, gland epithelial cell involved in secretion. Epithelial cell is having gland also, which is responsible for secretion of excessive or extra or waste products from our cell to outside. Epithelial cell have two types of gland, endocrine gland and exocrine gland. Epithelial cell has two types of gland, endocrine and exocrine gland. What is the function of endocrine gland? Secretion released to the bloodstream, not to surface. Hormone regulate body process. It means in endocrine gland, secretion released to bloodstream, not to surface. Whatever secretion is required from these epithelial cell, most of the hormones are required to run most of the body system. So, this is the endocrine gland which is made up of these epithelial cells. They secrete required hormone to perform or carry out the function of all system, cannot work without hormone. So, hormones are secreted from these endocrine gland, and the secretion always comes from gland to the bloodstream, not from the outside the body. Second is exocrine gland. What is exocrine gland? These are gland which is connected to surface by tube. It means the inside body is connected to the external environment. Those gland which are having opening outside the body is known as exocrine gland, and those gland which are having its opening inside the bloodstream or inside the body tubule is endocrine gland. So, the main function of exocrine gland, they secrete sweat, earwax, saliva, digestive enzyme onto free surface of epithelial layer. It means these gland which is present inside the epithelium cell, they secrete waste product like earwax, saliva, sweat gland, like tongue. Tongue is having, outer covering is epithelial cell. And whenever we see anything which we like most, we start releasing saliva. When we are feeling heat, we start secreting sweat, etc. Next tissue present in our body is connective tissue. Most abundant tissue in body. Most of the body system, body tissues, body organs is made up of connective tissue. As I have told you, epithelial is the outermost covering of body or cell. Epithelium is epithelial tissues form, epithelial cells form most of the outer covering of body, organ or system. But apart from epithelial tissue, all most of the system like bone, like muscle, tendon, nerve, cartilage, even smooth muscle, they all are made up of connective tissue. So, connective tissue is a very much important tissue in our body, and most abundant, it means maximum amount of tissue type present in our body is connective tissues, not on free surface. It is not like epithelial tissues. It is one end is exposed. As we see, all whole the skin is made up of epithelial tissues. But connective tissue, it is covered from both end. It is not on free surface. Cell separated in matrix, ground substance plus fiber. It means if we chemically analyze the composition of connective tissues, it is made up of ground substance and fibers. Ground substance means some fluid like material along with fibers, so base as well as fiber. So cells separated in a matrix, it means when you see the tissues are having some fiber, then cell, fiber, then cell. Good nerve and blood supply except cartilage and tendon. All connective tissues have maximal amount of neural supply as well as they are having maximal amount of blood supply, but the exception is cartilage and tendon. Cartilage and tendon, both tissue system, both structure are also made up of connective tissues, but they are having deprived blood supply. That's why we always try to save these structure from injury, because if you will have any injury in either cartilage or tendon, they will have less probability of healing. So why these structure is having less probability of healing? Because of precarious blood supply, less blood supply in cartilage and tendon. Even they are made up of connective tissues, but, and we all know connective tissue is having enough blood and nerve supply, but these tissues, cartilage and tendon, are exception. They don't have enough amount of blood supply, so they don't have enough capability of healing. And we can classify tissues, connective tissue, on the basis of matrix component, arrangement and type of protein fiber. In the matrix, how these fiber are arranged, and by seeing their arrangement, we can classify the type of connective tissues. On the basis of function, we can classify connective tissue in connective tissue proper, fluid connective tissue, and supporting connective tissues. Further, we can classify connective tissue proper into loose and dense. What is loose? Tissue proper and dense. Fiber create loose open framework. When any tissue, any structure, any body part is made up of proper connective tissue, if it is, the fibers are arranged in loose and open framework, we will say this is an example of loose connective tissue proper. And when the fibers are densely arranged, we will say it is the densely arranged connective tissue. Second one is fluid connective tissue. The example is blood and limb. Blood, like muscle, tendon is made up of dense connective tissue. Tendon is made up of dense connective tissue, whereas muscle is made up of loose connective tissue. The example of loose connective tissue is muscle. The example of dense connective tissue is tendon and ligament. Now come to the second type of connective tissue, that is known as fluid connective tissue. The example of it may be blood or lymph. Blood and lymph are also made up of connective tissues, and they are also the example of fluid type of connective tissue. And the third type of connective tissue is supporting. The main function is supporting the structure. So cartilage and bone. Cartilage and bone is made up of supporting type of connective tissue. And the main function of cartilage and bone is supporting the body weight. Cartilage is going to support our body weight by absorbing the axial shock, whereas bone is giving a framework to our body, and it is bearing the body weight as well as giving the protection, giving support to many of the vital structures of the body. Now come to the cell type of connective tissue. So blast type cell divide and produce matrix, fibroblast, chondroblast and osteoblast. First type of connective tissue cell is blast type. Blast type means which is having capability to grow, regenerate. So first type is blast type, and the example of blast type connective tissue is they have property to divide and produce further matrix. The example of this type of connective cell is fibroblast, chondroblast and osteoblast. what is the function of fibroblast? Fibroblast is a cell which is responsible for regeneration of fibers. If there is any injury in muscle tissue or any type of connective tissue, these fibroblast is having to reproduce new cell, new fiber to replace the gap. Next, second one is chondroblast cells. What is chondroblast cell? Whenever there is any injury in cartilage, these chondroblasts are having capability to regenerate and form new cartilage cell. And third is osteoblast cell is third example of this blast cell type. Whenever we will have any fracture in our bone, these osteoblast cell has capability to grow and fill that gap produced by fracture. So first type of this cartilage type cell is blast type, and in blast type there are three type of cell: fibroblast, chondroblast and osteoblast. And second type of connective tissue cell is site type cell. What is site type cell? They are mainly mature cell that cannot divide or produce matrix. So we have seen blast type cell mean those connective cells which is having capability to regenerate. But site type cell, they don't have capability to regenerate. They are basically mature cell that cannot divide or produce matrix. They are basically chondrocyte and osteocyte. Chondrocyte and osteocyte are those cells, they are not able to reproduce their own type of cell. Other type of connective tissue cell is immune cell. Immune cell are responsible for prevention to body from further infection. Adipocyte cell, they are basically fat cell, and fat is a stored form of energy. Next is plasma cell. It is present in blood plasma. Mast cell produce histamine that dilate small blood vessel. Mast cell is a cell which is present inside the tissues, and it is active whenever there is any injuries in any type of tissue of body. This mast cell become activated, and whenever these cell will be activated, they will release certain chemical known as chemical mediator of inflammation. And because of activity of these mast cell, they will be able to secrete some chemical mediator of inflammation. Basically they are histamine, bradykinin, enkephalin, substance P. And whenever this chemical will be released in those area, this chemical has capability to dilate the vessels of those areas. So because of dilation, the more amount of blood will come in those areas and produce inflammation. And inflammation is the first response of any injury. So this is the mast cell. And various stem cell. Stem cell, nowadays there is a new concept of stem cell therapy. Stem cell is the, you can say it is the basic cell of any man. It can be utilized for accelerating growth. It can be used for replacing those structure which cannot be reformed. So stem cell is the reserve type of cell. Stem cell is a reserve type of cell in our body, especially in umbilical cord and some of the hip bone. So these cells are the completely genotype cell. They are completely having all genetic characteristic of the individual. So these stem cell can be utilized for different intervention process. And last is mesenchyma. Mesenchyma is the middle covering of any tissue, is made up of mesenchymal cell. So now come to the ground substance. As I have told you, connective tissue is made up of ground substance and cell. And we have discussed about the different types of cell of connective tissue. Now I am going to discuss about the ground substance. What is the ground substance which is one of component of connective tissues? Ground substance support the cell and fiber. It means all the cells of connective tissue and fiber of tissues is embedded in the ground substance. They help to support them, help to determine the consistency of matrix, fluid, gel or solid. Ground cell is either fluid or gel-like material or solid. So ground substance make a base for arrangement of cells and fibers of connective tissues. And ground substance contain many large molecules. Hyaluronic acid is thick, viscous and slippery. Chondroitin sulfate is gel-like substance, provides support. Adhesion protein bind collagen fiber to ground substance. These three, hyaluronic acid, chondroitin sulfate and adhesion protein, they all make ground substance. It means they provide a base for arrangement of different cells of connective tissue and fiber. Now come to the different fibers of connective tissue. Collagen fiber, 25% of protein in our body. Our body, whatever protein is our body is having, 25% of protein is utilized in formation of collagen fiber. And what is the function of collagen fiber? They resist pulling force. Collagen fiber, whenever you apply any pulling stretch, they will resist. In tendon and ligament, all collagen fiber or collagen fiber, they are present in tendon and ligament. So whenever you will apply any stretching over ligament and tendon, they will resist. And they are rope-like structure. All tendon, when we see muscle, muscle is made up of tissues, tendon. But tendon are thicker. And so muscle is made up of cell, but tendon is made up of fiber. So I have told you, connective tissue is made up of three components, muscle, cell, fiber, and ground substance. So fiber and cells are embedded in ground substance. So come to the fiber. First is collagen fiber. 25% of body protein is made up of collagen fiber. The main function of collagen fiber is resist pulling forces in tendon and ligaments. They are looking rope-like, and the tendon is having elastin protein. What is elastin? Elastin is a protein which is present in lungs, blood vessel, and ear cartilage. What is elastin protein? Elastin is a specific type of protein which is having a great property of elasticity. Whenever you will apply any stretch over this protein, they will expand itself. So elastin protein is maximal amount. In maximum amount, elastin protein is present in ligament and tendon. And what is the specific property of this elastin protein? Whenever you apply a stretch, this elastin protein has capability of recoiling by 150% of its length. Suppose if a tendon is stretched 1 centimeter, so the tendon elastin, because of presence of elastin protein, the tendon will be able to recoil by 150% of its original length. Now come to what is the function of this fiber? They are mainly responsible for support. They are giving support like tendon and ligament. Tendon is binding supporting muscle to bone, and ligament is binding bone to bone. Now I would like to discuss something about the defective collagen and elastin. I would like to elaborate something about the different three type of tissues. First was connective tissue proper. They are dense connective tissue. Dense regular means ligaments bone to bone. Ligaments is made up of dense connective tissues. Tendon is also made up of dense connective tissues. It means muscle to bone. Next tissue of body, that is we have heard about aponeurosis. Aponeurosis is a broad ribbon-like structure which covers the tendon, is known as aponeurosis. It is also made up of dense connective tissues. Elastic tissue, high proportion of elastic fiber, walls of blood vessel. All blood vessels is having a property of elasticity, and all blood vessels is made up of elastin type of connective tissues. Now come to dense irregular connective tissues, mesh like arrangement of fiber, dermis of skin covering of bone periosteum, and capsule covering internal organs of system. So the dermis of skin, bone periosteum, and capsule, joint capsule, all are made up of dense irregular connective tissues. Now come to second type of connective tissue is loose connective tissues. Why they are loose? They are also known as two type of tissues. There are two type of, one is Euler tissues, open framework, lack of organized structure, deep to dermis, epithelial lining of digestive, respiration, urinary, and elsewhere. So loose connective tissues are present in deep to dermis, epithelial lining of digestive tissues, lining of respiratory tissues, urinary tissues, and anywhere else in the body. The second type of loose connective tissue is adipose tissues. What is adipose tissues? Converted from Euler on demand. Whenever body need more adipose, the Euler tissues can be converted into these adipose tissues. Padding, insulation, energy storage. The main function of adipose tissue is giving padding somewhere, insulation mean covering some of the structure, and energy storage. Cell are largely having oil droplets. Now come to second type of connective tissue, that is fluid connective tissue. The blood is the example of fluid connective tissue. It is formed by element as well as plasma. It means blood is having three type of cell, RBC, WBC and platelets along with a plasma. And second example of fluid connective tissue is lymph. And lymph is having interstitial fluid and lymphocyte. So lymphocyte of body and interstitial fluid is made up of lymph. And lymph is an example of fluid connective tissues. Now come to third type of connective tissue is cartilage. Cartilage is almost avascular. Cartilage is almost avascular and it is having made up of cells as well as matrix. Matrix is made up of proteoglycans. What is proteoglycans? It is a complex of protein and conducting sulfate. And surrounding of perichondrium is also made up of support connective tissue. Now come to cartilage. Cartilage is other tissue. It is mainly three types. First is hyaline cartilage, second is elastic cartilage, and third is fibrocartilage. So cartilage is also important tissue and made up of a non-regular connective tissue. Next is bone. Bone is the other form of tissue. Bone is made up of osseous tissues. Bone is made up of osseous tissues, and bone is highly vascular structure and it is having capability of regeneration. What is regeneration? Regeneration means whenever any damage in any tissue, the tissue is able to regenerate, reform, reproduce a tissue by same as previous. Whereas the other mode of healing is repair. Repair means when there is any damage in tissue, the tissue doesn't have capability to replace that loss by the same tissue. So bone is a highly vascular tissue and it is having a capability of regeneration. Metabolic, high demand, high nutrients and oxygen requirement. Bone is, because it is having high vascular structure, it need more nutrition and high energy to perform its function. Bone is also dynamic. Osteoblast build while osteocyte break down, hormonal regulation. Whenever there is any injury in bone, osteoblast form new bone, so we need more energy. Okay, we are discussing about the osseous tissues. They are highly vascular and they have capability of regeneration. They need high nutrition as well as oxygen requirement. As well as when we see the composition of osseous tissues, they are basically made up of collagen fiber along with deposition of some inorganic salt, that is mainly calcium phosphate. And when we analyze the bone, it is made up of 1/3 of DCT and 2/3 of calcium phosphate. And the bone develops through the process of ossification. What is ossification? When a child born or when there is fetus, he is having more amount of connective tissue in the bone, but as the time process, there is ossification, means deposition of more calcium phosphate in the bone lamella, and bone becomes stiffer and stiffer, and we will say the bone is ossified. So there are two basic types of bone. One is compact bone and other is spongy bone. What is compact bone? When the amount of stiffness, when the amount of calcium phosphate is more and there is no air spaces between the cavities of bone, we will say the bone is compact bone and it is harder bone, it can bear. So all the shaft, all the diaphysis of bone is made up of compact bone, whereas the weight bearing areas of bone, that is mainly epiphysis, which is having more air spaces, is spongy in nature, that is having more air space, is responsible for absorbing shock. So the bone end or the bone which is going to make a joint is made up of spongy bone. Now come to the muscle. Muscle is a specialized cell containing myosin and actin. Fibers with reduced contraction or movement. Basically, there are three types of muscle: smooth muscle, cardiac muscle, and skeletal muscle. Last topic is nervous tissues. Nervous tissues involved in sensing and conducting and analysis of information. Whatever is going on around us, whatever is going on inside our body, is signal transmitted to our brain with the help of these sensory and motor signal. We are able to control the environment with the help of motor signal, and we are getting able to perceive the all happening of the surrounding with the help of our sensory nerve. So our nervous tissues is made up of two types of cells, sensory cell and nervous cell. and the basic functional unit of nervous tissue is neurons, which conduct. Neuron is the nerve cell. Neuron is the nerve cell which is having cell body, axon and dendrites. So neurons which conduct impulses, what is neuroglia, which support neuron by providing support, production and nourishment. Neuroglia is a structure which support neuron by providing support, production and nourishment. The next topic of discussion is characteristic of life. Characteristic of life. What is life? All creature, all animal in the world has life. And what is the basic property? When we will say the person or the animal has life, and when we will say this is dead. So what is the difference between a living thing and a non-living thing? How? What are those features on the basis of which we can decide this? This is a dead part, dead object, and this is a living thing. So the living thing exhibit a number of features, number of characteristics, and by seeing those characteristics, we can say that yes, this person or this animal is having life or this is not having life. So let us discuss some important features of a life. Now first is characteristic of living bodies. All living bodies has an orderly structure. It means whatever you see, all living body has an orderly structure, like they have different system, order, in order, like respiratory system, like cardiac system, like blood, like whatever cells, organ, etc., etc. So whole body has a hierarchical of a system, like cell will form tissues will form organ will form system will form a whole body. So all living being, either from a single cell animal or a multicellular animal, they all exhibit an ordinarial body system. Ranges, the first and basic unit of life is cell, and when many cells unite, we will say it is tissue, and when many tissues unite, we will say it is a organ, and many organs make a body system, and many body system make a complete animal or man. So we can say a life, a person or animal who is having life, they will have a orderly organization system. Second, they have capability to produce offspring. It is the property of only living thing, either it is plant or animal, they both have capability of producing same offspring as they are. So they have capability of multiplication. And third thing, growth and develop, adjust to change in the environment. The third characteristic of life, the living things has property of growth and development. It means they are able to grow. Like you can see a plant, a seed can grow into a full-fledged tree, same as a sperm or a ova, when they meet, it will result in a full-fledged man or animal. So any person or individual, if he is living, he is able to reproduce his own offspring or child. This is the third basic characteristic of living thing. And fourth thing, they are having capability to adjust themselves according to the change in environment. Suppose if we are living in a ice area, cooler area, so our body is having some adaptation, so we can adjust it in that environment. Same as if some animals are living in hotter area, their body structure is designed or accommodated in that condition, so they can lead a proper life or healthy life in that area. So our body is adapted, or living body has certain adaptation according to the environment. So this is also one of the most important feature of living thing. So living thing can adjust, accommodate himself or herself or itself according to the external environment. And the next feature of human living is using energy. If we are living, we will use energy. It means for any function, any movement, we need energy. And this is the one of the most characteristic feature of living thing. First, I would like to discuss about the orderly organization. लिविंग क्रिएचर्स आर ऑर्गेनाइज्ड, ऑल मेड ऑफ सेम कलेक्शन ऑफ केमिकल, बट वी आर ऑर्गेनाइज्ड एज मॉलिक्यूल्स, एंड द बेसिक मॉलिक्यूल विच मेक अ लिविंग बॉडी इज प्रोटीन, फैट, कार्बोहाइड्रेट एंड न्यूक्लिक एसिड. So all living creature, all living material, either plant or animal, the basic molecules which form a living thing, they are mainly protein, fat, carbohydrate, nucleic acid, and living bodies have orderly structure. As I have told you, they have cells. Cell, what is cell? Cell is the smallest unit of life. Living thing may have either one cell or number of cell, and when all the cells unite, or most of the cell, number of cells unite, they will form a tissue. What is tissue? Group of cells that perform a common function. And third, what is organ? Group of tissues that perform a common function. And what is organ system? A group of organs that perform a common function. I would like to give you some example. Like tissue is a parenchymal tissue, colenchymal tissue. Same as organ, like nose, like any hand, these are the organ. And what is the organ system? When many organs unite and perform one function is known as group of organ. Like upper arm, is having forearm, shoulder, wrist, hand and finger. When they all unite, they can perform as a organ system. And when many organ system unite, they will form a organism. An organism, any complete living thing like man, animal, anything is, we will say it is a complete living thing. So all made of same collection of chemical, but we are organized as cell, plant cell and animal cell. You can see in the diagram, animal cell and plant cell are almost same. The only difference between plant cell and animal cell, the animal cell is having outermost covering is living, where the outermost covering of plant cell is non-living. That's why we, an animal being, we are able to move. We have some more feature than plant, but plants are still living, but they have less feature than us. The second important feature of living thing is make the next generation. All living things, all living creature are able to reproduce their own child. So how they produce their gene, it is because of reproduction. What is reproduction? The production of their own child. Necessary for a species to survive, not necessary for individual organism to survive. Clear? So why we reproduce? We are trying to produce our species. So our species could go on in longer time. Two types of production is possible. They can produce, living thing can produce their offspring by two methods. First is asexual type and second is sexual type. What is asexual type? Parent offspring identical to parent. When anything is produced by asexual means, like in amoeba or single cell animal or most of the plant which have vegetative growth, when you break, they will develop into. So if anything or if any plant or animal is able to generate its offspring of own kind without having sexual relation, we will say this is the asexual means of reproduction, like our somatic cell, like our amoeba, like plants. And the second is sexual. For sexual thing, there are two parents are required. One should be male, other is female, and by having proper contact between male and female, when ova and sperm unite, they will form a new offspring. And this type of offspring production is known as sexual means of reproduction. What is a species? A species is a group of organism that can intermediate and produce fertile offspring in nature. So why living thing produce their own child or offspring? Because to alive their species. The next characteristic of living thing is living body changes during their life. So how they can have change during the passage of time in their own life? One person is looking child at one stage, then he will become adult, then he is young, old and die. So human or living thing has a property of continuous change, or in other words we can say he is having property of development and growth. So what is growth? Growth result in an increase in the amount of living material and the formation of new structure. And how we can achieve growth? It is only by the cell division. What is cell division? One cell is able to unite into two and grow. So cell is having property of multiplication, and by having the property of multiplication, cell can grow, and because of cell growth we will increase in our length, girth, etc., etc. And all of the changes that takes place during the life of an organism are known as its development. What is the difference between growth and development? Growth means something is increasing. What is development? Development may be anything. It may be going towards increasing or going towards decreasing. So when you see a child or fetus to grow from very small size, it will grow older and older and young, taller and taller. After some time, he will achieve a fixed height, and it is the maximum amount of growth. Then we will have some development, not growth. Development means he may have some increase in his body characteristic, he may have some decrease in his body characteristic. Like with the age, he will have more intelligence, he will have more experience, but it is one kind of development. Same as he may lose some body tissues, he may have be weaker, he may have some lose some tone. So it is the continuous process. With the passage of time, living thing has a property of growth and development. The next characteristic of living thing is they can adjust themselves to their surrounding. How living things can adjust themselves to their surrounding? Anything and organisms, external or internal environment that causes the organism to react is a stimulus. Whenever we will apply any stimulus over a living organism, it will respond. So what is a stimulus? It could be in any form. It could be from the environment, from weather change, from fear, from anything. Any stimulus, if you apply over a living organism, it will respond. And this type of phenomenon is known as property of excitability. What is excitability? When you apply any type of energy, any type of change, he will respond. So all living things has a property of response, and this response is especially more seen in animals. A reaction to a stimulus is a response. Next feature of living thing is sensitivity. You know what is stimulus? Any kind of energy, any kind of stimulus is applied, he will respond. Suppose if you apply something hitting over his arm, he will either drag or... So this is the only living thing which is able to respond against an stimulus applied by anything from either environment, from other man, from other creature, from anything, he will respond. This is the one of the other characteristic of living thing. The next characteristic of living thing is sensitivity. What is sensitivity? The ability to detect the our sense change in the environment and to make response. So body or living thing also having sensitivity for external changes in the environment. Suppose if we are living in a hot weather, we will try to wear very light cloth, but when we are passing our life in winter days, we will use more warm cloth. Same as migration of birds from polar areas to other areas, when there is change in weather, they will shift to this side, and when the season change, they will again go back. So all living things has property of sensitivity. They are sensitive to change in external environment, and they will have capability to accommodate, adjust themselves according to the change. So sensitivity is the one of the other feature. They are able to feel, they are able to sensitize his surrounding. The next feature is response. Response is one of the other feature of living thing. Whenever any stimulus is applied in terms of stimulus, whether the stimulus is damaging or stimulus is supporting. Suppose if you give help someone, he will oblige to you. If you hit someone, he will try to respond to you. So response is the other feature, and living thing responds according to stimulus. If stimulus is good, they will respond in good manner. If stimulus is bad, they will respond in bad manners. Same as response and a stimulus is a most important characteristic of living thing, which is most very much important for sports and physical education. An athlete cannot perform well unless he will got enough stimulus. So by having the sensitivity of stimulus, we can increase or decrease our response. So where we can respond to our internal changes in our body. Suppose if we have some infection in the body, and because body is having infection, there will be some increase chemical reaction in our body. And because of increased chemical reaction in our body, what happened? Our body will produce more amount of heat. So if that amount of heat will retain in our body, it can damage the cells of our body. But because body is sensitive enough to perceive the damaging effect of that increased heat, so body will try to excrete that excessive amount of heat from outside the body, and that is fever. So what is the stimulus? Stimulus, you can see here, stimulus was the infection, and because of infection, body, there was a number of reaction in body, and because of reaction, there was production of heat. So what is the response of body? Body is trying to release that excess amount of heat from body in form of fever. So we can say here infection is stimulus and fever is response. So by these type of response, these are internal response. Whenever we will have any type of imbalance, any type of disease, infection in our body, our normal body homeostasis. What is homeostasis? It is body response to some physiological changes. Body is trying to control any problem by itself. Body has a property, all living bodies has a property to control its internal problem by itself, and that controlling mechanism is known as homeostasis. Suppose if you have a loose motion or dysentery, what happened? Your GI system need more water. You will feel thirsty. Why you are feeling thirsty? Because you need, your body is losing water in by one way, so body is trying to get more water to compensate that loss. Same as when you are running fast, your breathing increases. And when you are running fast, your breathing increases. It is homeostasis. It is a homeostatic response of our body. Because when you are running, you are using more energy. And when you are using more energy, for more energy, you need more oxygen. So from where more oxygen will come? When you increase the respiration rate, you breathe easily, you breathe fastly, so more oxygen will come. And when you breathe fastly, more CO2 will go out. So body is having capability to respond against any internal or external changes. So body can respond with reference to different type of changes in the environment, and this type of response could be internal if the changes it is adjusted from body itself is known as homeostasis. Next is living body adjust to their surrounding. They are having capability to adjust themselves in their surrounding. So, regulation of an organism's internal environment to maintain condition suitable for its survival is called homeostasis. What is the adjustment of body? Like if you can take example of those people who are living at high altitude or hilly areas, they have more amount of oxygen in their blood. Why they are having more amount of oxygen in their blood? Because at higher altitude, normal atmospheric oxygen is lesser. At higher altitude, normal atmospheric oxygen is lesser. So they need more hemoglobin to hold more oxygen. So they are having more oxygen. Same as if you see the European people and African people. African peoples are black and Americans or European people are white. Why? Because the normal temperature of Europe is very less. That's why their skin don't need more protection from the sun or UV rays. But if you see the African people, they have very dark and thicker skin. Why? Why they are having this thick and dark skin? Because they are highly exposed to sun there. They are having high temperature there. So if they will have thin skin or softer skin, it could burn. So they are properly accommodated themselves or their skin according to the environment. Next feature of living organism is respiration. It is the most important feature What is respiration? The chemical reaction that break down nutrients molecule into living cell to release energy. As I have told you, all living organism needs energy for their living. Clear? But from where its energy come? Whenever we eat food, the food is digested, then absorbed in form of energy packets, glucose, mainly glucose. And glucose is the main source of energy. But glucose alone cannot give us energy. For getting energy, when first glucose will go to cell, and in the cell there is mitochondria. Mitochondria is known as powerhouse of cell, energy house of cell. So when your glucose will go from GI system to mitochondria, but that glucose alone is insufficient to produce energy. But when oxygen will come through blood to mitochondria, oxygen will unite with glucose, and it there will be a chemical reaction, and because of union of glucose to oxygen, it will release carbon dioxide, water as well as energy. This is the mechanism of energy production. So we have seen here, oxygen is very much important for energy production, and oxygen could not reach to the level of tissue until unless we don't have respiration mechanism. So respiration is the one of the most important feature of living organism. Next thing, living creature uses energy. What is energy? Energy is a form of power. Energy is a form, by using energy we can perform most of the, or we cannot perform any activity, anything, or we cannot live without energy. So how can we use energy, and from where the energy come? All the reactions your body perform to make and use energy. Whatever reaction is going in our body, even if we want to grow, even we want to divide our cell, for every and each action of body, even we want to, if we want to breathe, our heart want to pump, any system will not work without energy. So for functioning of any of our living organism, we need energy. So from where energy come? Energy come from eating and digestion and elimination of waste, synthesis and building, cellular respiration and making. So energy is a complete process. Our body is able to produce energy by utilizing different system, working different system. They are working for, all systems are working to produce energy. All system like heart, like liver, like kidney, like muscle, bone, all are working together in coordination for the production of energy. Living thing, the next feature, living thing adopt and evolve. What is this? Any structure, behavior or internal process that enable an organism to respond to environment factor and live to produce offspring is called adaptation. Adaptation means, as I have discussed before, adjustment of a living thing from the external environment. And adaptation are inherited from previous generation. Adaptations are inherited from previous generation. It means whatever properties, whatever qualities we have in our body, we get it from our forefathers. So adaptation nature of human being or living thing is like a lion is always living in a forest, because he has adopted that character, that characteristic of living in forest because of his or her parents. Same as we are living in houses, we have adopted this property from our parent. The gradual change in species through adaptation over time is known as evolution. If there is any change, suppose nowadays in this era we are having 5 fingers, but after 1,000 years, 10,000 years, if a man is having 4 fingers, we will say it is evolution. So a process of slow changes in a specific organism, is known as evolution. And next characteristic of living organism is movement. What is movement? Property of changing place. The person or part is able, or living thing are able to move one part from other. Any action by an organism or part of an organism causing a change in position or place. So all living organism, rather than except plant, if we are talking about animals, all living animals has property of movement. Next property of living thing is excretion. What is excretion? Removal of waste product. Any removal from organism of toxic material, the waste products of metabolism and substance in excess of requirement. We eat, we take many things, but all sometime we inhale something, but all sometime all things are not necessary. And whenever we utilize something, because of utilization of something, there is some waste. So all waste material, all metabolic waste or any excess material which is not required in our body can be excreted out with the help of either skin or with the help of nose, with the help of mouth or with the help of kidney. So any waste product which is not required in our body or any excess product which is not required for a living thing is excreted out by a different mechanism is known as excretion. There are four ways in which bodily waste are excreted from the body. First is urine, second is feces, mean bowel movement, third is perspiration, means sweating, and fourth is carbon dioxide from exhaling, either from mouth or from nose. We don't need carbon dioxide because whenever we will have more carbon dioxide in our blood, it can change the pH of blood. So we don't need carbon dioxide. So we will exhale from nose. We don't need extra urine, extra water. So it is released in form of urine. We don't need undigested food. So it is released in form of feces. We don't need excess electrolytes. So it is released from the sweat. So these are the specific characteristic of living thing. I would like to summarize again. A living thing has a property of movement, reproduction, sensitivity, nutrition, excretion, respiration, and growth. Nutrition is one of other important characteristic of living thing. Without nutrition mean a living thing needs a protein, carbohydrate, fat, amino acid, fat, minerals and vitamin for its bodybuilding and growth. So all these are the main features of living thing. Thank you.